Welcome to today's video. In this video, we're going to go over the skills that it takes to be a senior software developer. We will be covering what those skills are, how to present those skills in an interview, and also what steps to take to move into a senior role.
Welcome to the Life at Miro channel. Let's get started. Hi, my name is Alyssa, and I'm our technical sourcer for engineering.
Hi, my name is Elliot Monifi, and I am a senior engineering manager in enterprise.
So some of the things that I look for in an interview, basically, we have about 30 minutes, so I have to get through kind of a lot of content really quickly. So some of the things that I'm checking for, because I'm not so much deeply technical in the way that Elliot is communication skills and style. Are you clear? Are you structured? Do I understand kind of the journey that you're taking me on? I know that this is really important for you too. How do you assess like communication when you're speaking with candidates?
Yeah, for communication, generally we do behavioral style interviews. And so when you're doing a behavioral style interview, you want the interviewee to be telling you, taking you on a journey, telling you a story about the time that they worked on a project or a time that they dealt with a situation, right? Yeah. And so being able to coherently form that story so I understand what happened, how they were part of that story, where they fit into the puzzle is very important in understanding what their role is, what skills they have.
What their scope is.
Exactly. Yeah. And so if there's not a fully formed story there, it's very hard to really get what they're trying to tell you and where they were doing something or their manager was doing it or somebody else on the team, because they're not being very clear. And so communication ends up being the number one thing that we're looking for in these calls.
People will say we did, whereas it helps to be more clear when you say I drove or I led, I did this thing. That way I have a very clear idea of what it is that you did rather than like kind of what the team did overall.
And with that, you can also mention which parts your manager did, which parts other members of the team did, because you can't do everything, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Especially as a senior engineer, many times you'll be taking the requirements from a PM or somebody else on the team, and you'll be breaking those down so that other engineers, less senior engineers, will pick up that work. And if you're not doing that work, that's okay to mention, right?
Yeah.
You may be instead focused on things like designing the architecture of the system or some other aspects, or communicating with stakeholders, working cross-functionally. There's so many other aspects to being a senior engineer that go way past what the other engineers' roles are. Are there any, because you're doing the recruiter screen, right?
Yeah.
And I feel like in the recruiter screen, you're obviously looking for clear signs that this person hasn't made it to that senior role just yet, right? So that we know that it's a fit from the start, right? What are the signs for you that are clear that this person is not ready yet for a senior role?
Well, we already kind of touched on communication style, but I would say kind of the scope of the overall work.
That makes sense.
So are you, what I'm looking for senior basically is, have you implemented basically from the beginning the overall plan you need to execute the initiative? So meeting with stakeholders, breaking down those requirements. Also after the initiative is done, are you still maintaining it? And if you don't have those things, then that makes me think maybe not quite a senior right now, but definitely we can get there.
And then generally after your call with them, we go into those more technical interviews, right? And in these technical interviews, we start assessing, especially in the system design interview, we start assessing more of the technical skills that we see from the candidate, right?
Yeah.
Their ability to adapt to new technologies, to do research on those technologies, understand what is out there and how they can use them to build a system that has multiple services with lots of different communication between the services, know when which pieces of design best fit and where to make the greatest trade-offs to make resilient systems that can have millions of customers, which Miro does, right?
Yeah. Something I always talk about in my initial screening with candidates is just how important the system design is for Miro. Here, you touched on it, is kind of breaking down the requirements? How are you considering what some of the trade-offs are? And maybe, for example, if one of the interviewers doesn't ask you or asks you something that you may not know the answer to, still making a decision and still sticking with it, even though right now it may not be the best thing.
Yeah, I think the big thing there, right, is that even if you don't, if you've never, let's say, worked with every piece of technology, not everybody can.
Yeah.
But when you get that list of technical and non-technical requirements from the interviewers in that system design, to be able to understand what it is that are the goals and that come from those requirements, and understand that, hey, when I'm picking out a cache, when I'm picking out a database, I may not know all the options that are out there. I may default to one that I've used before.
Yeah.
But if I know that the one I've used before doesn't meet the requirements, then to even say that in the interview, hey, I would go do research for on these things. I'm looking for a cache that is best for X, Y, and Z, and it should, I don't care about that other thing. And so that you show that you can go out there and investigate, because nobody has all the answers all the time, right? And there's also some maturity there to not just throw out, hey, I'm going to use
this buzzword here and there.
Exactly, because we'll find it out and then you won't do so well. That doesn't show the maturity of a senior engineer. And then generally after that round, right, we get into the behavioral rounds, right?
Yeah.
And we have two of those.
Yeah.
And that's where we start to get a little bit, it's a little bit more of a mix of soft skills and technical, right? And those will be a little bit more project-focused interviews, though we do sprinkle in some other questions, right? And I think the biggest item for us here on the seniority, and I think you've heard this from us a lot, feedback for the candidates, is the ability to pull from a large resource of examples.
Exactly.
Right.
And having clear, personalized examples. That really, I mean, you said this in the beginning. It really helps to wrap your head around what it is that the person did. This also shows that this person is thinking and storytelling in a structured way.
Because one of the problems we see is a lot of times people will use the same example multiple times in one interview.
Yes.
Or over separate interviews, even though the question is widely different. They just adapt an answer as much as they can, right? And this usually shows that they just don't have the experience that we're looking for from them, right? They have maybe one really good example and they're just trying to use that again, which is fine, right? And experience will come with time, and it comes with working and getting to run into really challenging things. And each one of those comes with learnings. And I think learnings is the next thing I want to talk about here, and I think is really key for a strong engineer, is that strong engineers also, they learn from both their successes and their failures.
Yes.
And so I feel that when you're doing the interviews, being able to call out areas in which you succeeded or failed, and what you learned from those, and how you have taking those learnings back into your work is really key to being a senior engineer.
I think this is also like a clear marker of a senior. Like, of course you failed, but how do you kind of implement the failure and take it to, like, turn it into a positive, basically? Another thing I am always looking for when I'm speaking with a senior, and something that's like a clear indicator to me, is feedback. How do you give? How do you receive feedback? How do you ingest it? When you're working on a team, it's really important that you're like actively soliciting feedback. Okay, how can I improve on this? What can I do? Does this work? Does this not work? And that is what a lot of our teams do at Miro. We find feedback really important.
Feedback is kind of one part of a greater, ability for people to not only learn themselves, but also help other people learn and grow, whether that's part of mentoring or part of I think this falls into the same place as feedback, but, being able to, let's say two people are challenging each other on a single solution or path forward technically or even non-technically, And sometimes you may find yourself convincing others, but sometimes you also may find yourself being convinced, right? And someone who's senior can not be stubborn and can be like, hey, look, that person's right. We should go with that one. And or even, you know, the term that we use all the time, disagree and commit, right?
Yeah.
Because someone who's truly senior doesn't always hold their ideas as part of themselves.
A lot of what is the most important, in addition to the technical skills, are the soft skills, because you need to be able to like fit on the team and work in a way that basically you're not the blocker, you know?
Yeah. I would actually say that soft skills are usually the biggest hurdle for an engineer to take to get from the normal software engineer role to a senior engineer, because the technical chops are something they've been working on for years. But at that point, they haven't been thinking about leading other people, working across teams, working across functions, their communication skills, and usually that's the one that's lacking, right? And so it actually is quite challenging for them to learn those skills. But I do think it is possible, and I think that's the kind of the next area I wanted us to talk about, which is kind of how do you, what are the steps that an engineer can take to move into that that senior role? At Miro, we have a pretty well-defined rubric for doing that. We call it the career matrix. It has a set of 8 individual competencies and 1 what we call a core competency. And generally, the idea of this is it gives the engineers something to build their IDP off of, their individual development plan. Generally, what you would want to do as an engineer, whether you're at Miro or outside of Miro, is you speak with other more senior engineers on your team, you speak with your manager, you receive as much feedback into these development areas as to where you believe you're strong and where you happen to be weak, right? And we can't expect everyone to be perfect at everything, but generally you want to hit as many of these competencies as possible.
Yeah.
And so when you find your weaknesses, you create a plan as to how you want to develop in those areas.
Yeah, and the career matrix for us is like a clear, defined structure. Everyone has access to it. And so you can kind of see like what level you are at now and what you can do to take yourself to the next level. And as much as it is on your manager and business need and stuff like that, it's really on you and what are you going to do to get there?
And I think the best part about it is that by clearly defining it, at least within Miro, we have a baseline of what it means to be senior, right? Yeah. There's not as much of this, you know, everyone being at different levels. It's pretty calibrated across the organization. Yeah. This is what we believe a senior is. These are the things that they contribute to the company. These are the skills that they have, which is really a great. And it also makes it very easy for non-engineers to go in and be like,
see what it is that you need.
Yeah. Exactly. And I know that you recruiters have been using it quite a lot too, to understand what it is we're looking for in these roles.
Yeah. Another thing I wanted to mention, and this goes kind of hand in hand with the matrix, is impact. As a senior, basically the work that you're doing needs to be visible and it needs to have an impact on not only your team, but on customer business metrics.
Yeah. No, I agree with you. I would say that all of the little individual competencies that we talk about are just a way to hone your skills. But when someone truly becomes senior, generally here at Miro, we believe it's somebody who can take a pretty complex project, break it down for potentially up to 5 engineers within their team to pick it up and deliver successfully at Miro. And additionally, that project should have a pretty strong impact at the company, right? It should be moving some of our objectives and actually making a difference. And like you said, this generally brings visibility back at that senior engineer, because they most people will know that they're the one who helped drive this project to completion, right? Yeah.
And something I touched on earlier is not only driving the project to completion, but maintaining it afterwards.
Correct.
Because it's easy, or I don't want to say easy, but anyone can kind of get a project across the line, but then what do you do with it after it's done? Yeah. And how do you kind of keep it up and continue to make an impact in that area? As you are getting more senior, I did mention this a little bit at the top, but How do you communicate with non-technical stakeholders? And that is something that I'm also looking for. I'm not the most technical person, but I need to be able to understand, okay, what did you do? How do you break it down so that someone like me can clearly understand and digest what your impact has been on the org? For you, like, what is one of the kind of clear markers that somebody can communicate non-technical, like with someone non-technical?
Generally, if their manager doesn't have to step in. No, I'm kidding around there a little bit. But generally, you know, for some of the really complex projects that we have, especially within the enterprise stream, which is the stream that I'm working in, a lot of times you may have to get involved with other teams, like even the legal team at the company or the security team or some of these other teams that may not be as technical, or you're speaking to the, you know, CPO or COO or some other role at the company. And when you're speaking to people in these roles, they don't understand the technical implications of the things that you're mentioning, right?
Yeah.
And we would prefer for a senior engineer, and we expect for a senior engineer to not have to pull anyone else into that conversation, including their manager, right? They should be able to hold that conversation pretty easily on their own, right? And break down those very technical challenges into something that's digestible and the other person can understand. So the final topic that we were hoping to speak with you today is picking between the individual contributor track, which is more like a senior software engineer, or the management track, which is an engineering manager. Once you reach this fork in the road, especially here at Miro, you have to start understanding which skills you're looking to hone. As a senior engineer, you need to continue focusing on those technical skills and start asking your manager for larger and more complex projects that are potentially going to have an even larger impact on the organization as a whole. If you instead try to speak to your manager about going into the management role, this is where you need to start honing your kind of project management skills, your people management skills, delivery, some of the other skills that maybe you haven't been focusing on over the previous years in your career. If you want to hear more about this, we actually have another video that we'll be posting, and this will dive deeper into this topic.
We covered quite a lot of content today. Are there any skills that we missed? If so, please comment below.
Thanks for watching, and if you liked today's video, please subscribe to our channel.